In all of these, I see for a king, for a ruler, for a leader, there is no exemption for not getting involved in the battle. At the time when the kings go, they must go. David wasn't given any kind of clearance or any kind of leeway through these examples of why, or an excuse as to why he couldn't go and take part in that fight. Now, because David did not what was according to the manner before, the manner of kings going to the battle, the manner that he had always, year after year, gotten involved in, because he didn't do it, because he broke from his manner, this is why I say that consistency is so important, because he broke from the routine, he sinned in the flesh, didn't he? He was overcome by lust. Not only that, right? His laziness brought him to a point where he's up in the middle of the night, he sees something with the eyes, and lust conceived in his heart and became a sin of the flesh. Not only that, he lied. He deceived to cover up. He tried to get Uriah to go lay with his own wife to cover up the great sin that he had done. He even murdered. The Bible says that when Nathan confronted David, now his sword didn't touch Uriah the Hittite, but he gave the command to set him in the heat of the battle, withdrew the men from them, so that he was vulnerable and able to be destroyed. And when Nathan came to David, he said, "Thou art the man. You're the murderer. You're the one that killed Uriah the Hittite in this case." But not only did he sin in the flesh and get involved in lying and murder somebody, he came to spiritual ruin. When at the end of all of these things, it was said, the thing that David had done displeased the Lord. And as a young child, I mean, you probably remember growing up, your parents being angry at you, punishing you, that was one thing, but almost the worst thing that could ever happen to you as a child, to your parents, was if they were just like, "I'm not even going to punish you, I'm just disappointed." That was the worst. That was like crushing, to have your parents just disappointed in you. You're almost like, "Please punish me. Please ground me or give me spanking or something." But if they're just disappointed, that's worse. That indicates a separation has taken place. And God here indicates that he was displeased with what David did. He didn't want nothing to do with that. He said, "You were a man after my own heart. Why did you fall?" And you know why David fell? Because he broke from the routine. He ceased to be a consistent believer. And this is why routine is so important. This is why I believe church is so important. I want the doors open because I want Christians to keep their routine going. Because if we break our routine, we'll end up like David. Up in the middle of the night, wandering around, looking about, getting ourselves in sins of the flesh, getting into trouble. Next thing you know, we're covering for our sins. This is what happens when people break from the Christian life and the routine of it all. I believe by shutting the doors, so many Christians are being forced to sin. I'm hearing it all the time of those that want to go to church and want to assemble with God's people and want to get the spiritual nourishment and want to get the fellowship, and yet the doors have been shut out. And so they're being closed off from having the assembling of ourselves together. They're joining up with the manner of some, right? Also, because they don't have the encouragement and the edification and God's people praying together and the accountability that comes with meeting with God's people, because they don't have that, they fall into even more sins and more trouble just besets them. They've broken from their routine. They always say that the Christian life is like fivefold. What is it? Like pray, read your Bible, soul win, go to church, and tithe, right? Well, if we just take away church, now you've got one of the five broken down. You know what's going to happen? Church is gone. Soon you don't have a group to go soul winning with. And then after that, there's really no reason to read your Bible because you haven't heard a good personal sermon that drew you in to hear more from God. You don't have a place to tithe because we're to bring it to the storehouse, the Bible says. It's really not the same to send it by the internet, which is what they've all been driven to do. And then why would you talk to God if he's not talking to you through his word? And the whole Christian life falls apart, and next thing you know, sin enters in, and lust is taken that direction, and then sin bringeth forth death in the end. Death in the life of the Christian. Faith without works is dead. You can believe and go to heaven all day long, but if you don't have works, you're a dead Christian. This is the problem that David ran into. He ended up in a state of God being displeased with him. Without faith, it is impossible to please him. Doesn't that tell you that David was also in a rut of unbelief? If he doesn't go into the battle, maybe it's just because he's doubting whether God's even going to help him in that battle. knows what was going through his mind when he made that decision.